You probably know that UpCloud provides the world's fastest cloud servers, but UpCloud also strives to deliver simple and yet powerful usability. And in this video, I will show you how easy it is to clone a whole UpCloud server, to clone only the storage device, and how to create a pre-configured template to deploy new servers with your custom settings. Let's get started. If you are not using UpCloud yet, give it a try. Use the promo code LU25 during the registration at upcloud.com and you will get $25 to your account. You can use them to deploy cloud servers and test all the features of UpCloud, including this cloning tutorial. Let's start with cloning a whole UpCloud server. This is the easiest and most straightforward way of replicating an existing cloud server. Note, this process requires the server to be shut down while it's been cloned, and the downtime depends on the size of your storage device. Before you clone a server, make sure everything is working as expected on your server. If you are running CentOS or Ubuntu, you first need to rename the current MAC address reference file. The system will generate a new file on the next reboot. Servers with other OSs do not need any special preparation for cloning. Next, log into your UpCloud control panel and shut down the server you are about to clone. Then, in the server's overview, click this down arrow and select Clone. You will be presented with this server cloning view, where you can do some customization before cloning. You can clone your server to a new location than your original server. Set the server configuration using simple plans or flexible plan. A cloned server will have identical storage device as the original server, but you can add new devices as needed. The OS, SSH keys and initialization scripts will be the same as in the original server. Lastly, name the clone server as you wish. And click to clone the server. You will then see a clone server appear at your UpCloud control panel. The cloning is relatively fast, but both the original and the clone server will be in the maintenance mode during the cloning process. You can see the process of the cloning under the Storage Devices tab. Once the cloning is finished, you need to start your original server, while your clone server will start automatically and you can use it right away. Now you have two servers that are exactly the same. This is my original server and this is the clone. There is already a LU user that I created on the original server. I can log in using the same password. Also, I have the same WordPress site on both the original server and the clone server. Now, let's clone only the storage device. Cloning the storage device is useful if you want to duplicate only the content, and unlike with the whole server backup, you do not need to shut down the original server to clone the data. To make a backup cloning, click on the server you want to clone and go to the Backups tab. Scroll down to the Take Backups Now section. Select the storage device you wish to backup and click on this Backup Now button. This will create a snapshot of your storage. Next, go to the storage backup list and find this snapshot. Click on this icon to clone the storage. Give this clone a name and click Accept. You will find the newly created disk among your storage devices and it will become accessible after the cloning is finished. And you can attach this clone storage to any other server you have. Just go to the Resize tab of that server, click Add New Device, select Attach Existing Device, and you will find the new clone storage at the top of the list. Select and attach it. Now, this storage will be available as another device on your server. You can mount it and check its content. Finally, my favorite feature, cloning a server to create a custom image. Using a custom image is a great time saver. Let's say you frequently need to deploy servers with a specific set of programs and your favorite settings. You can create a custom image for that and get all the programs and settings right during the deployment of the server. Let me show you how to achieve that. This is the server which I would like to use as a template. You need to shut down the server then open the storage devices and find the system disk attached to your source server. Click on this icon to create a custom image of this disk, give it a name, and click on the Create button. The imaging process will take a moment. The original server state will show in the maintenance mode until the imaging has been completed. Once the server is again in the stopped mode, the custom image is ready and you can start the original server. Now, next time you deploy a server, you can choose this custom image and deploy a new server, which will be exact copy of your original server. You can deploy as many servers using this template as you want. The only restriction of this approach is that the storage must be the same size as your original server, and it is deployed to the same location. After cloning settings. Cloning your cloud server means the OS level configuration will be exactly the same. This includes your usernames, passwords, and any SSH keys. That's why you can log into your new cloud system just as to the original one. However, once you're logged in, you may want to change the username, password, SSH keys, and hostname. I provide the links to the videos showing how to do that in the description. Here, I will only show you how to change the hostname. Open the hostname file and change the hostname here. And do the same for the file hosts. Reboot your system and you will see its hostname has changed. As you have seen, UpCloud control panel is very simple and yet very powerful. You can clone your servers with just few clicks. Moreover, you can create a custom server template to deploy as many servers as you need with your custom settings. This feature has saved me many hours I would spend configuring my servers. Just try it yourself. All the links in the description. Thank you for watching.